Welcome back. It is about 7 past the hour. And once again, if you're just joining us, I want to mention the reason we were not here Friday. Kathy was making a Thai dish, larb, and used some Thai peppers. All, you know, so far so good, but the pepper sauce that it came in, or the pepper secretions, got on her hands. And something that was a real shock to her. In 30 years of cooking, nothing like this ever happened, but she had a really bad reaction to this pepper juice, and her hands swelled up to the point where she couldn't run the board. So that was the situation we dealt with. We had to call our satellite upload people about 15 minutes before airtime and say we can't do it. So anyway, for whatever inconvenience, we apologize. It was just one of those situations that the larb, by the way, is delicious. But Kathy's hand, and her hands are okay now, you know. But if you've ever dealt with pepper sauce before, you know that it will not go away. You cannot get it off. It sinks beneath the initial layer of skin. Finally, the only thing that helped, and it was very temporary, was just pure alcohol. That was it. Pure alcohol, rubbing alcohol out of a bottle. And that relief would only be temporary. It was really sad to watch. There was no reason. I mean, no reason to go to an emergency care clinic. What the hell are they going to do? But anyway, that's what happened, and we do apologize for it. You won't be doing that again, will you? This hour is sponsored by Jenny. Her message, thanks, Mike. Keep getting the message out there. People listen and learn when they're ready. Some never. Listening to you talk about a different truth breaks up the day of nonstop Republican teabag mainstream media pablum. Being keenly aware of how focused the Republicans, the teabags, the birthers have been for the past 4 years at any cost, you're a welcome break during the day. Jenny. Thanks, Jenny. We appreciate that very much, the message and the sponsorship. What is Ann Romney's big worry about her husband being elected? Did you hear about this? She was in Nevada over the weekend, and she did an interview. Well, actually, it was Thursday, KTVN in that state. I guess it was Reno. Yeah, Reno, Nevada. And she told the person she was talking with at KTVN that her main concern for her, if her husband wins the upcoming election, would be his state of mind, his mental stability. Seriously, this is her quote, "I think my biggest concern, obviously, would be just for his mental well-being," end quote. And then she quickly added, "Well, I have all the confidence in the world in his ability and his decisiveness and his leadership and his understanding of the economy, his understanding of what's missing right now in the economy, you know, pieces that are missing to get this jump started. So for me, I think it would be just the emotional part." Oh, the emotional part. Well, your mental well-being and emotional state. That's a good point. A very good point indeed. His mental state, his mental well-being. Let them eat cake. I mean, you know, that's how I see Ann Romney now. I see her as someone who simply does not understand, doesn't have a clue. She doesn't live in the world that you and I live in. She just doesn't. And that 350 million Americans live in. She doesn't live there. Or 330 million Americans. She's worried about her husband's mental state if he wins. Well, just thought you might like to know that. That's right from the horse's mouth. No offense, Mrs. Romney. No offense at all. What else? Oh, yeah. Did you watch any of the Sunday slop shows? I did not. I can't watch them anymore. Like I've said before, I'll watch Sunday Morning on CBS, which is a wonderful magazine format program, which I really like. And then that's it. You know, local news, and then Sunday Morning, and then at 10 o'clock the TV goes off, and that's it. You know, unless there was football, like the Falcons game yesterday. Oh, my God, that was wonderful! But anyway, so I didn't watch David Gregory. I can't stand David Gregory. What he's pressed the meat, right? Well, yesterday morning on NBC's Press the Meat, or Meet the Press, I don't care how you say it, Gregory twice stated that in May, Barack Obama declared, quote, that Al-Qaeda has been defeated, end quote. Now, according to Think Progress, which posted this today, or Sunday, or no, today, Gregory used that claim to advance the theory that Obama was simply not concerned enough about Al-Qaeda in advance of the attack on the American embassy in Libya. That Obama was not concerned. It's not up to... Why start screaming? You know, it's not up to Obama. It's up to the CIA. The CIA, which is real good at infiltrating, assassinating, torturing, blowing stuff up, but it's not an intelligence agency. It's an agency of destruction. When in recent history has the CIA provided credible intelligence that was used to prevent something awful from happening either to the United States or to American personnel? Even in situations where Americans were deeply involved in places where they had no business being, if you understand what I'm saying. But the CIA is not, you know, it's not Central Intelligence Agency. It's Central F-Up Agency. That's what it is. And their function is to torture people, to lie, to obfuscate, to destroy, to infiltrate, to blow stuff up. It's an espionage, sabotage agency. Change the name of it. God damn it. How many intelligent so-called agencies do we have anyway? 30? 60? So any reality that the attack at the Libyan embassy that killed our ambassador, that somehow Obama? No. These people, David Gregory, you have it all wrong. It was George Bush that had his head up his ass when he was told by intelligence agencies Osama bin Laden determined to attack in the United States. But I digress. I'm sorry. So here's what he said. David Gregory, Sunday, on Press the Meat. Quote, the president has said as recently as May of this year that Al-Qaeda has not had a chance to rebuild, that Al-Qaeda has been defeated. There is an election, as we've been talking about, and the president's challenger said, plain and simple, the president failed to level with the American people and called this a terrorist attack. Because you had to be concerned about another terrorist attack from Al-Qaeda in the Middle East after the president said that Al-Qaeda had been defeated. Now, that is not, end quote, David Gregory. That's not what Obama said in May. Gregory apparently was referring to an address that Obama delivered from Afghanistan in May on the one-year anniversary of bin Laden's death. This is what Obama said, quote, and 1 year ago, from a base here in Afghanistan, our troops launched the operation that killed Osama bin Laden. The goal that I set to defeat Al-Qaeda and deny it a chance to rebuild is now within our reach. Still, there will be days ahead, difficult days ahead. The enormous sacrifices of our men and women are not over. End quote. That's what Obama said. So the truth is that Obama did not say Al-Qaeda had been defeated. That's George Bush, mission accomplished, hog snot. And he specifically, Obama, acknowledged that there were so-called difficult days and so-called enormous sacrifices yet to come. So once again, this little weasel bastard David Gregory over at NBC, and nobody at NBC comes out and corrects it. Nobody on MSNBC tonight will say a damn word about this. And it hangs out there. David Gregory's statement hangs out there. I mean, Jesus Christ, Gregory, why don't you just admit you're working for Mitt Romney? Are all rich and free, but they chained my mind to an endless tomb when they took my only son from me. I know it's true. Cause I saw it on TV.
it's true. Oh, so true. 'Cause I saw it.